In this tutorial, we're going to go over level of details for the Unreal Development Kit. Starting off in Studio Max, and what we're going to do, we're going to create a sphere, a diamond, and another object which is in between those two, so you get a varying degree of detail between. Now, what we're going to do first is create a sphere. And I'm going to give this one 32 segments just to make it pretty round. What's very important here is you need to center everything to the center of the world. If you don't do that, what happens with each level of detail is they'll be positioned differently the further away you get from the camera, which you don't want. So make sure to keep it all centered. Now we're going to create or copy and paste for the second level. We're going to give this segment 8. This would show up quite decently at a distance between the two. Center this one. And then we'll create the diamond-like shape with only 4 segments. And this needs to be centered as well. Now, I need to export all of these, and I need to be in an ASE format because that is what UDK reads. I'm not going to bother with materials because that'll be done straight in UDK. So we need to export each one. So select the round one, we'll go to export, export selected, and this is the base mesh. Now, base mesh is the first level, so I'm going to call it test level of detail B. And remember, it's an ASCII scene export ASE file. So save that. Click OK. Now we're going to do the same for the 8-segment version, which is the first level of detail when you go further away from the camera. So export selected one. Save that. OK. Now, what I'm going to do with the diamond is just to show you the importance of the world setting. So, I'm going to move it about one space away to show you know, just so you should know, that it should be literally on the same spot as every other piece of detail. Otherwise, you'll get problems. So, I'm going to export this, selected. This would be level 2, which would be the furthest from the camera. You can have a lot more level of details, but we're just going to do a few for now. Just going to click OK. Now all the objects are done, so I'll close Max and bring up UDK. Now I'm going to import only the base mesh because the other two will be imported via the object viewer. So just going to drag the ASE base mesh onto here. It's asking me for the package now. Seeing this as a test, I'm not even going to bother with packages or the groups. So, if the package can leave it as it is, this is a new package. Group, I'm just going to put test, it doesn't matter. And a test LOD underscore B would mean it's a base mesh, but we know it's a base mesh, so I'm just going to put test LOD. Click OK. And here you go, you've got the imported object, which is the round one. Now what we're going to do here is going to import everything, but as you can see at the top here you've got a set LOD auto setting. Now the further you move away from the camera, or the object rather, you actually see that the shape will change, but because we've only got one shape in here at the moment, it will stay the same. And you've got the base mesh, which is what this is, and then you've got a 1, 2, and 3. So in this case, UDK only supports up to 4 meshes for a level of detail, the base and 3 others. So you need to be careful with how you actually set your optimization for each object. But now what we're going to do is import the first level, and that will be set to level 1. Okay, and as you can see here for slit level 1, you get lesser, and that would be close up. Now if I change the level of detail maximum range, I can make it so that it's much further away if it's a bigger object before it changes shape, or I can make it much closer, like 256, so that it's not too far before it changes shape. Oh, I need to set it to auto first. As you can see, it's much closer now before it changes shape. Or if I set it to 1000, for instance, I'd have to go much further away before it changes. So that's another key area which you need to optimize your objects for. So now I need to import the final level of detail, which is 2. Click open, and I don't want it to replace the first one, but the second one. Okay, so that's done. And as you can see, move 1,000 units away, it's changed. And if I move another 1,000, now as you can see, if you remember, I moved the world axis away. Because of that, it's actually changed the position of the object, and we don't want that. So you need to make sure that when you create your objects, make sure it's all zeroed on the same space. But for now, I'm going to keep the object. Now I want to create a simple color variance between all three, so it make it again easier to see which one's which. So I'm going to right click, going to create a new material. I'm going to put it in the same test group. I'm going to call this red. So now I want to make a parameter, vector parameter. I want this red or a pinky red or any sort of color. I'll put that in diffuse and just click that, and that's done. Next one, I'm going to make a green. It's a new material. Call this green. Again, another vector parameter. Put it in diffuse. Make sure that it's set to green. Close that and apply it. And final one will be blue. So where's the material? Blue. Another vector parameter. Connect them. That's turned out more purplish, but that will do. Okay, now what we're going to do is, in a level of detail now, make this smaller. So we're going to select the red, and we're going to put this on the first level. So you can see, or the base level, I should say. So on 0, click the green arrow, and it's now red. Then for level 1, I'm going to use blue. So click blue, back to here, selecting blue. So now if you can see on 1, it's blue. And finally, green will be the final level. So select level 2, hit green, and there you go. So now that's all set for this. We are now going to just create a simple map so that we can actually show them all. So we're going to put it at 2560. Let's just add 10 to it. So add it. Now I'm going to add the ball, just simply dragging the static mesh to the screen and bring it up above through the wall. As you can see already in a few ports, it's a diamond shape. It's because I'm too far away, but the closer I get, as you can see, it's now blue and now it's red. So you can already see the distance, the LOD changing in a viewport, and I can actually change this again if you remember. If I double click it, and I can change the max range here. If I did it 256, for instance, actually, no, 512, it would actually be much closer now, as you can see. But we're going to try this in engine. So I need to add a light source, a simple spotlight, bring it up, build all of it. Okay, just ignore all the errors. Going to play from here. And as you can see now, if you move about, it's now a diamond, a ball, and a circle. But as you can tell, that because it takes time to change the level of detail, this is another reason why it should be on top, but it's kind of makes it look rather strange if you don't have photos of the same area. Because what happens is, as you move across, it loads it on top, what happens is that when you move towards or away, it loads the next level of detail underneath. Then when it's fully loaded, it removes the other level of detail that isn't needed. So as you can see here, you move close, it's fully loaded, and then it unloads. And the same happens there as well. So you need to keep that in mind as well. And yes, that's exactly how you create a level of detail. And this could be done for any objects, skeletal, actors, literally anything in game, but it must not be a BSP, it has to be a static mesh. BSP is a solid geometry which is created by the engine. Static meshes are imported, so you can literally do anything you like with them. So I hope this has helped, and good luck with your other stuff.